Where are they? This is taking forever. They didn't even say what this was for, just that the Aldori were looking for heroes. Who are the Aldori anyway, rich folk?
I don't really like to interrupt when I'm like reading and stuff, but I'll narrate what I'm saying, so not what they are.
If you can't be patient, no one's keeping you here. Just go back to your mountains or whatever hole you crawled out of. The Aldori sword lords run the premier school for the dueling arts. They're also the richest and most influential group in this part of Brevoy. Take that tone with them, and they'll teach you some manners pretty quickly.
All right, you purple toad, just shut your trap. And if you can't, I'll help you.
Hush! Quiet! They're coming.
Greetings, everyone. I am Swordlord Jamandi Aldori, and this is Lord Mayor Yosef Selemius of Rustov. Welcome to my mansion.
We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for responding to our call. You may be few, but that's unavoidable. We need only the best of the best for this task. And I see true heroes before me, strong and fearless, exactly what Rustov needs.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Now, to the point. South of here, just beyond Brevoy's border, lies a region known as the Stolen Lands. This is disputed territory, and while it's long been claimed by nearby states, it's never been truly taken. I won't bore you with the legal technicalities. Suffice to say that anyone with enough courage and power to seize the Stolen Lands and name themselves Baron or Baroness, claiming dominion, well, none of the neighboring states would be able to challenge it. Of course, Rustov would be first to recognize the legitimacy of this new state, as well as the noble title of its founder. Unfortunately, one serious obstacle stands between you and this title. A gang of bandits holds sway in the Stolen Lands. Their chief, who they call the Stag Lord, considers himself the rightful owner of these lands, and no one has yet been able to challenge his power. Bring me his head, and you'll be able to return to the Stolen Lands as their legal ruler. Any questions?
There's a whole team of us who exactly will receive the Baron's title.
I will, of course. I'm the leader of this team, after all. Don't worry, though. I'll make it worth your while to help me.
We haven't yet begun, and you already speak of divvying rewards. What makes you think we'll even succeed? There's little point arguing over who gains the title when we'll most likely lose our lives there.
If I may please answer the question. We believe you're all equally deserving of a noble title. Over the course of your expedition, it will be up to you as a team to decide which of you is best suited to rule.
Why not just recognize the Stag Lord as Baron?
That's a good point. As I see it, this Stag Lord already holds power over the region with confidence. Many noble bloodlines were started by bandits who just got lucky, weren't they?
Perhaps because we do have standards to maintain. This room has seen many celebrations of adventurers, and even those who just got lucky. But giving a noble title to a bandit lord? That's one thing that's never happened here, and it won't while I still breathe.
You're helping us found the barony. What do you gain from such generosity?
Don't ask stupid questions. Why should you even care? What they have to gain and why, that's for Lady Aldori and I to discuss. It's none of your concern. Your only concern is to swing your sword around or whatever it is you do.
Of course, we stand to benefit from this enterprise. But if you're concerned that we intend to rule your country from afar, using you as a front, well, please know that these concerns are unfounded. Let's just say that we have a strong interest in the region's stability. We have need of a ruling power we can negotiate with, not bandit gangs and monster hordes.
What rewards can we expect exactly?
And what reward would you seek beyond a noble title and your own lands?
We'll absorb the costs of preparing and equipping your expeditions. Once you return victorious, Restov will also allocate you a significant sum to provide financial support for you to establish your country. Essentially, we'll help you build your capital. I hope such a reward is satisfactory.
Words, words, words. Significant, financial. I can't fill my belly with pretty words.
Of course, there will also be an official banquet held in your honor. All of Rostov's high society will gather to celebrate your feat.
Now you're talking.
Excellent. You venture forth tomorrow. For now, you can take some time to get to know one another better. Or you can head straight to your guest rooms to get some rest. You'll find we've already prepared supplies for you there. And thank you again for agreeing to take part in this expedition. I wish you luck.
Thank you again, with all my heart, for replying to this call. The flare in your eyes reveals your courage, the unshakable will that distinguishes true heroes. I look at you, O champions of Restov, and doubt not for a second that you'll be victorious. So venture forth toward your feet. Go! And return in triumph.
Hi, my name's Lindsay. I'm a bard, though this is my first real adventure. So, shall we go teach this stag lord a lesson?
We sure will. Just wait. We have plenty of great feats in store.
I have no doubt. Kind of related, I wanted to ask you something. How do you feel about this Tartuccio fellow? I think he's pretty obnoxious, personally. He appointed himself head of the team, and he's just after the Baron's crown, or whatever it is Barons wear. Doesn't matter. I don't like him. I think you should be team leader. When I first saw you, I couldn't help but think, now here's a real hero. Someone who'll be praised in poems and songs. This is the person I'll write my book about.
Wait, a book? Wait, what?
Damn, I should have led with that. Please, just let me explain. You know what the trouble with most heroes' biographies is? They're always written years later, based on the tales of, best case, people who saw things from the outside. Worst case, someone heard about it from their brother, who heard it from their friend, who heard it from their cousin, and so on, adding a new batch of lies each time. Every time I read about a heroic journey, I think to myself, why didn't they just bring a bard with them to write it all down properly? And then I thought, I could be that bard. I just needed to find a suitable hero and volunteer to follow along on their glorious adventure. A great plan, huh? And here we are, with a heroic journey lying before us. Who's going to be the hero? Some dwarf who keeps muttering about how we'll all die? Or maybe that horrific scythe lady? Or, gods forbid, Tartuccio? No way.
Not a bad plan. It's settled then. I'll accomplish the feats, and you'll write them down.
Deal. All right. I'm going to my room to write about tonight. See you in the morning.
Okay. Let's move on to next area. There's like only adventures around here, and only interaction I get it like, hello, what are you doing? Okay. I'll just go, just walk all over here and just finish this area. What's going on?
The mansion's under attack. We need to help. Some villains broke in and started killing everyone. I barely made it. Hurry, we have to help the guards fight off the attackers or we'll all be cut down one by one.
Okay. Hello there.
I am superior!
You can see the initiative check, like 9 for me and 40 for him, so he starts the fight.
Out of my way!
Can I charge him? No. It's not far enough.
Okay, run
let's
them
go for
through.
It. That was easy. Okay. Take this. I think it's better than mine. Yep, let's do that. Okay. Check in here. Nothing more. Okay, let's go.
I won't be halted.
Okay. I chose a bit strange voice for the guy. It's aggressive voice, like a barbarian. Okay, let's just take all here. Check it out later. Lindsay Turner contains your current quest. Go here and see the... Yeah. Leave the hall, follow Lindsay. Just read the other stuff if you need more information. But I think the game tells you enough. Oh, where am I running?
Cut them to pieces!
Come on, charge him. When that...
Let's hear you cry.
You're just in time. A bit longer and I'd have been... I don't even want to think about it. Can you imagine what a terrible loss this would have been? But it's all right now. I'm safe, sound, and unscathed, ready to lead you to victory. Lady Jamandi's holding the line in the banquet hall. You know, the one where she had us gathered before. We need to make our way to her. And along the way, we'll try to save some of these dummies who are supposed to accompany us to the Stolen Lands. Speaking of dummies, take this ring. Quiet now, so that little fool doesn't hear us. She might try to steal it herself. It's magical. It'll protect you. You'll need it while you work to defend me.
Appreciate it. Let's loot just everything. Okay, he gave me that ring to equip, and I'll just double click on it, drag it inside suitable. Yeah, we know how this works, so we don't really have to go through everything. Let's put again one arm.
And Lindsay was
time
called
wasting. Wait.
I don't tolerate
smooth already.
What's in here? Copper ring and money. Let's just close this. Okay, I've already been there.
We do it my way.
Okay, there's somebody in there.
Anything is possible.
Let's prep a spell for her. Let's daze one target. I'm gonna pause. She's gonna daze this guy.
I deserve better.
Gonna do Ray of Frost on this one, and
all this waiting bores me.
Charge him.
They dare to attack me?
Okay. Okay, one, two left, one to go.
Die!
Fire.
Out of my way!
Serves you right.
Okay, let's loot these guys.
And so they
I'm
walked
losing
up.
My temper.
There we go. Okay, we're not holding that much.
No one stands in my way.
It's like really angry at
onwards.
Everything. 6 pounds, 25 pounds. Is it better than I have? No, it's not. I wonder if she get benefits from it. I could take this. I could put it on you. And you could wear this. This makes the stronger, like she had only 16, now she has 18. That's a good improvement, so like this. Wow, that's quite a ring she has. Oh, she has two scrolls, okay. let's go over here. Check this room. We have a dead orc and somebody here.
I wrote it like I saw it.
I always have a second plan.
Oh, look at you there. Quite far away. Butter, fowl, edible. I'll take this. It's a cooking book. I think it could help, like, an adventure. Maybe you can cook or something.
I lead. You follow.
Okay, silver ring. And 35 points. Wow.
Look for Gorum!
Oh, there, the barbarian friend.
It's an Amiri. For you.
You deserve it.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, it's you. Stay up from under my feet or I'll strike you down. Blood for Gorum!
Okay.
Barbarians.
I think that's exactly how heroes should be.
What? Stupid, sweaty, and always looking for something to gobble up or lop the head off of? Callistria, save me from such heroes.
Okay.
We do it my way.
And we did it my way. Okay, a little bit of clipping. One of their own.
I won't be halted. Battles await.
Sometimes interacting with an object requires a skill check. A special check may be needed for a variety of tasks. Unlocking a door, opening a chest, disabling a trap, moving a heavy object, reading an inscription in an ancient language. The different skills are used for different checks. If multiple characters are selected at once, the character with the highest skill bonus will perform the action. Some skill checks like trap disarming can be attempted multiple times, other like unlocking door or spotting hidden things can only be retried after a character raises their skill rank. Sometimes spells can give characters a bonus to a skill check, but applying this bonus doesn't give you a chance to retry.
All this waiting bores me. Spell's not working like that.
And Lindsay was called forth. Any last wishes?
Let's make this quick. Leave this one to me.
What troubles you?
Spell's not working like that.
There we go.
Spell's not working like that.
Little hurt.
Applause, please.
She opened the door. She seems to have lockpicking.
Let's move already.
Okay. said we could highlight infrared object. Yeah, okay, it's okay.
Head on!
What have we here? This chest is full of gold. I guess it's for the guards' salaries, all things considered. Well, those freeloaders don't seem to have been working too hard for it. Maybe we should pocket it instead.
What? No, we're heroes, not thieves.
Who said we were stealing it? We'll just take the gold for safety so the assassins don't get it. And then we can heroically return it to Jamandi when this is all over. How would she know it was us and not the assassins? Unless someone planned on telling her.
I'm not
Don't drag me into this. You do what you want, but I'm not taking a single coin.
Nah, it's not. I don't think it's worth it. Let's keep it there.
We do it my way.
And we did it my way. Yeah, I'm encumbered now. Each character can carry a limited amount of weight based on their strength score. Each character carries the weight of their personal equipment as well as part of the party's shared stats. There are three stages of encumbrance: light load, medium load, and heavy load. Medium and heavy loads are burdening the character, limiting their abilities in battle. You can see the penalties a character currently suffering due to their carried weight by pointing in the encumbrance gauge under the character's equipment window. I'm gonna check one thing, okay, because when I switch between them, it's like the same stuff.
Oh, familiar faces. I hope you're not so frightened as to swing at every shadow. It's me, Jaethal. I don't recommend advancing down the hallway, assuming you value your life, of course. There were a few people with me, and you can see what happened to them.
And just how did they all end up dead while you don't seem to have a scratch?
I'll answer but briefly and just once. Further scares and explanations will wait until we aren't being hunted by a group of assassins. Deal? All right. I'm undead. These traps are deadly to the living, but they're harmless to me.
Is this undead? Cool.
What do you mean undead? Really? Like zombies or skeletons or...
As I said, further explanations will wait until later. All you need to know right now is that we're on the same side, and we have to fight off a small army of hired assassins. Let's get to it.
You will encounter many traps on your adventure. When any characters approach a trap, they will automatically make perception skill check. On success, you will see the trap location and the game will automatically pause. Traps vary in effect as well as difficulty to detect. Having identified the trap, you can click on it or order one of the characters to make trickery skill check. To disable it. On success, the trap will be disabled. On failure, it will remain in a place. However, if the result of a skill roll is less than a trap difficulty by 5 or more, the trap will go off as the character had triggered. All check results can be found in the combat log. Okay. Yeah, it lowered down. The more you have in a party, the more you can hold. Okay, collect all.
Onwards! Over there!
Just letting the ink dry. Anything else? I see something. I failed. I'm sorry.
Just do it again.
It's just not my lucky day. Applause, please. Would you look at that? Applause, please.
Everyone is mortal in this world, especially when I'm around.
Anything is possible.
I hate having difference between characters. I just want to have the same level, so they gain the experience, but not again gain experience. Achievement. What can you use? Okay, you can. You have two. Okay, and you have a chainmail. So that's not better.
I'm losing my temper.
I'm losing my temper. I'm losing my temper. I feel my temper growing.
You found the scroll, a single use item that allowing you to use a spell that written upon it. For a character to use it, that the character must have the use magic device skill or be a class which could eventually learn to cast the spell. For convenience, it is best to place things like the scroll and character quick slot. Okay, quick slot.
Battles await.
I'm very cheap on scrolls.
I lead. You follow.
I rarely use them. So.
What are you dallying for? I tell you, Juma. Kashi has to be here somewhere.
I hurry up.
Can you make an epic pose? I need inspiration.
Okay, you.
Spell's not working like that. Spell's not working like that. Spell's not working like that. Run them through!
This is where I step in.
You die already!
Save for the last fight.
Unworthy.
Spell's not working like that. Spell's not working like that.
Secret room.
I wrote it like I saw it.
My patience is a running thin.
Ask.
Right.
Okay, it seems to be about the puzzle. The secret room. Okay. Let's push this one. Okay. Seems we need to get everyone down because it's stuck the whole game. What happens here?
All this waiting bores me.
And Lindsay was called forth. By your side. Adventures call to them.
Let's move already.
Just letting the ink dry.
No one stands in my way.
I only need one guy to put it down.
What troubles you?
This guy.
I'm losing my temper.
Anything is possible.
Did we get experience for this? A little bit, I think. I'm not sure. Maybe. Maybe not.
Battles await.
Hey, buddy. I'm getting useless because I'm playing another game that there's like this follow system. You just move one character and the other one follows. So in this case, you have to choose.
I won't be halted. All this waiting bores me. Spell's not working like that.
And Lindsay was called
I don't
for. And then our leader charged forward. Hey, wait for me.
Let's hear you cry. This is not the end.
What the hell? How did they get a sneak attack? Really?
Oh!
That was immensely powerful.
Time to get my hands dirty again.
Oh! Despicable!
I got like... It was 19 damage from two guys.
Serves
sneak
you right!
Attack. And I saw them and they were not... Running.
Never had a chance.
It's crazy.
We do it my way.
And we did it my way. I like seeing that every time he says that.
Grotus, I can sense your silhouette hovering over me. It won't be much longer. Soon we shall meet, O Lord of Oblivion.
Aren't you being a bit premature? Look at yourself. How did... Got a scratch.
That's impossible. Oh, it seems you might be right. Yeah, it seems I will live. I suppose I must postpone meeting my god, not for long, I'm sure. But while we remain in this transient world, Arim is at your service.
Like looting everything and then it's super slow because of it. That's the I was looking for that thing. Any victory, the formation system will help line of combat. Select one of the standard formation. Okay.
Onwards!
Okay,
You, run and get an axe. You, bring more water. You, stay here and hold our defense. Those assassins are still around here somewhere. Aha! Some of our guests survived. Good. You need to get to the banquet hall and help Lady Jamondi.
Keston, House Garrus, a fighter in the service of Sword Lord Jamondi Aldori. Right now, I'm in charge of the mansion guards. As you can see, there's a lot to do.
What's going on here?
Someone opened the gate, let in a group of assassins in the middle of the night. Now they've set the mansion on fire to cut off access to the hall. They don't want Lady Jamondi to get reinforcements. We cleared the passage so you can get through. Just try to avoid inhaling the smoke. We'll be right behind you. We just need to put out the fire first to save the mansion. No, we'll manage. I've got my best people here, those who still live. Your place is by Lady Aldori's side.
It doesn't seem right. What if some of the guards are wounded? We need to help them.
Where's the hall?
You'll have to run through the fire. We've almost put it out at the entrance, so your main concern should be to not inhale any smoke. Hold your breath and take the first right, then head straight down the hallway.
I'll go immediately.
May Abadar keep you safe.
About the code of the city's law of merchants and law. Okay. Let's go through here. Illustrated book episode. Some game events play out as illustrated book episodes. The decision you make during these episodes can have a drastic impact on the development of the game's plot. As with dialogues, you will often need to make various skill checks during these episodes. Depending on the circumstance, sometimes you will need to choose one of your party members to perform an action, and sometimes an action will be automatically performed by the character with the highest skill. And so our adventure started earlier and much more tragic than we'd expected. The whole team who'd gathered in the hall yesterday had been reduced to but a handful of brave souls led by Torbodol. And not all by that scoundrel Tartuccio, no matter what he might have imagined of himself. Jamondi Aldori was waiting for us, but to get to her we'd have to march through fires, literally. As we approach the burning building, we drench ourselves with buckets of water. Prudence is the key to victory. Before moving through the fire, we thoroughly wet our clothes and hair. After that, we covered our noses and mouths before we rushed inside. So we hadn't wasted any time. Drenching the building and taking just a few steps forward, the wall behind us slanted and crashed down with a terrible crackling sound, blocking the way back. While we may not have planned on going back, if you'd come in a little later, the flaming logs and red hot bricks would have fallen right on our heads. Regardless, we were left with only one way to go. The hot air burned our lungs and our eyes watered from the smoke, but Torbodol led us stubbornly through the flames, while Tortuccio did nothing useful at all. We'd made it to the hallway leading to the banquet hall when we heard someone calling for us. It was Valerie, one of the guards I chatted with bit of the banquet hall. Even then, in that calm setting, I'd been stunned by her beauty. But now, amid the smoke and flame, she looked like a celestial avenger. An armored deity, menacing but beautiful and merciful, descending from the higher sphere to help us poor mortals. She held a burned, barely living guard in her arms. "There are two more," she shouted. "There are wanted. Help me put them out." Tartuccia grumbled something about how Jamondi was waiting for us. Meanwhile, Torbodol rushed to save the guards from the fire. Having the poor fellow didn't take long. Together we lifted them up and carried them away from the fire. Only then did Valerie pause to catch her breath and wipe the sweat from her face. "Thank you, that was truly noble of you," she said. "And now, let us rush to Lady Aldori aid." Ensuring the guards we rescued were relatively safe, we made our way to the hall, where the battle was already in full swing. We should get rid of some like stuff that's not really worth having, but yeah, okay, let's drop this. draw. Okay, and drop, 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 and drop. I'm gonna check one thing. Do you get more out of using... Even if I have less dexterity, do I get more armor? Yes, I do. I think I'm gonna keep it that way. A little less damage, but... Okay, I think we just got it now. Okay. No, not okay. Well, okay, now it's too late.
This waiting bores me. Out of my way!
Okay, I'm gonna charge this one.
I am your shield. Let us strike as one!
Dear, demoralized.
Do not falter!
Share your will.
Yes,
what
I'm still
you
here.
Do you need some magic? I need this to fight.
Repent!
Anything is possible.
My patience is running thin.
What troubles you?
Who will prevail? Does it matter?
Where does all this sneak attack come from? What the fuck is this? They were not flanking me. In a little bit. I don't get it. I just get
sneak attack from everybody.
Whoa. Serves you right.
Kill this guy.
Ethno.
That's really weird. Wait. I go into fight and I get sneak attack. What's up with that?
Thank you for your valor and bravery. The enemy was strong, but you were stronger. And that means I made the right choice. Just as I thought, there were worthy leaders among you. I'm especially grateful to them for the courage and common sense they showed while defending the mansion. But this attack means we have even less time than I thought. Someone already knows of our plans and is acting against us. You'll begin your expedition immediately.
Lady Aldori, please, I know who arranged this attack. The vile king of Pitax, Iroveti. What's more, I know who among us works for him. Hey, you! Show everyone the ring you're wearing! You think I wouldn't recognize Iroveti's seal? That's why he wasn't killed. The bandits recognized him as one of their own by this signet ring.
Tartuccia trying to set me up. He's the one who gave me the ring.
Yes. Such a gambit would be typical of Iroveti and his henchmen. And yet, it still seems suspicious. There's definitely a spy among us. But who? All I have is one word against another. I'm afraid you're both under suspicion.
I bet my life the spy's anyone but this man. I saw how he dealt with those creeps with my own eyes. A true warrior. I'd go with him through hell and high water. This purple crook, on the other hand... he's got the eyes of a spy! And the mug of a spy!
Lady Aldori, don't listen to this thick-headed barbarian. She doesn't know what she's talking about. During the attack, our leader showed his true colors. He forced us to break into the armory and rob it. And not just that. Upon finding the guard's salaries in the armory, he immediately pocketed it all.
Considering the circumstances, that was more than reasonable.
That was a sound decision. Sometimes one must act at one's own risk and peril until crossing the boundaries of what is allowed. Showing initiative is no crime.
Well, of course, theft is not to be condoned. However, when the fire burns around you and you are but one step away from death, is it not insane to worry about laws and rules?
What about that trick he pulled right before we came in here? He knew very well you were fighting the enemy, but instead of rushing to help you, he dallied as long as he could, dropping everything to save people from the fire, even though the guards were handling things just fine. He was obviously hoping to show up too late and find you already dead.
People were dying right in front of me. How could I just walk by?
Trying to save others is commendable, but Tartuccio's right. You were needed here more.
May Shellen spare me from ever having to make such a choice, but he behaved decently as a true leader.
A true leader is someone who has their priorities straight, not someone who would put a valuable ally's life in danger for the sake of some servant.
Enough squabbling. I'm still not sure which of you I can trust. However, the risk of entrusting the whole affair to a spy is too great. Here's what we'll do. Two teams will head out. That way, I'll know at least one group can be counted on to serve my interests in the stolen lands.
Lady Aldori, most of those who were to set off for the stolen lands have been killed. Those who yet live will require help. Please allow me to join the expedition.
I'm sad to lose such a talented warrior. But you're right, Valerie. They have greater need of you right now. Go, and may Abadar keep you. Which of the two teams would you prefer to accompany?
If my leader allows, I would join his team. He seems a worthy commander in my eyes.
Commanders, military leaders, all these laws and rules are but dust and vanity. I suppose I will accompany Tartuccio.
Our leader
leader is good in battle, but I don't like all the spiritual agonizing. I prefer those who can act without wasting time helping every little pipsqueak. Those like Tartuccio.
Ugh, Tartuccio's going to take the credit for himself and be done with it. Shellen, spare me from such allies. I'm going with you. You're a hero worthy of my quill.
I don't even need to think. I'm coming with this man. As for you, Purple Toad, just wait until we meet along the way. I'll be sure to hang your rotten spy guts from the trees.
All right, we have two teams. To avoid unnecessary conflict on the road, you'll each take a different route to the Stolen Lands. Tartuccio's team will go through Navactus Crossing. The Garrison Commandant will provide him all the help he needs. You will take your team to Oleg Levitin's trading post. He's been complaining about the Stag Lord's bandits for a while now. There, you'll be provided with all the necessary travel supplies. I'd like to believe you, but I know all too well how convincing traitors and spies can be. If you're truly innocent, I hope you can forgive me this precaution. While you're away, Keston will investigate the night's events and learn who in Restov is working for Patox. But you should know that it isn't just Patox we need to worry about. The Royal House of Sertova may also interfere in our plans. I've managed to keep this affair a secret from them so far, but that can't last long. By my estimations, you have no more than 3 months. After that, any feats you accomplish will be pointless. And now, farewell. This battle was but the first ordeal along your path, and you overcame it as true champions of Restov. May the obstacles that follow also fall to your feet. Fear nothing, my friends, and return victorious.
Woo! Finished, almost finished the prologue. I think it's like a little bit left. The first step on the road to glory. I write the same. We just finished. Okay, never mind. I can't finish reading it. I can't finish reading it. I feel so sad.
Surviving a terrible night, our small team set off to brave our fate. Beware, Stolen Lands. Heroes are on the way.
Here's a map of the Stolen Lands and their vicinity. To set out, click on one of the arrows near their party. You can learn the whereabouts of significant locations by talking to characters or happening upon during your journey. After learning about a location, you must find the way there yourself. Along the way, random encounters await you, may be attacked by monsters, or you may meet new acquaintances. After exiting the location of a random encounter, you will be not be able to return there. Okay, that's better. Okay, and then we push this button. Wow, that's a whole map. Quite a big place. There is someone on the road. Get ready. We got some Hylacine. Okay, you charge this one.
Spell's not working like that.
Oh yeah, I'm encumbered.
Out of my way!
Let us strike as one! Tear them apart!
Serves you right.
Golem!
Okay, I was not sneak attack this time. Okay, I'm gonna loot these guys. Skip. Okay, and then we're gonna try resting. Oh, nice. Maybe like tents. And we push here. And this is screen 4 here for total, and we can push the manage button. Okay, plus 7, plus 0, plus 4. Okay, let's go. Hunting, you kind of attempt to hunt the surrounding. The main hunter makes a roll against the RDC to determine outcome each additional character. he seems to be the best cook. But can you... Okay, 5. It depends on the character put in here, what extra stuff I want to happen. Maintain armor. Let's make a hearty meal. Like this, okay? Okay, and
my cape is all worn out. Gotta catch a bear. A big one's hide would fit me just right.
Okay, hunting took 7 hours. Hunted for its boot equal to 4 rations. Camp camouflage is successful. The chance of being attacked has been lowered. Maintain armor. Still camping, making the wall again. You see, a main cook prepared an excellent. Okay. And I think we just keep on going. I think we can't do anything more. Yeah.
I won't be halted.
I'm Lindsay, author of the book, My Dear Reader. Hold in your hands. I once the agony of terror to attacks. Cool. Let's fell off the map. Okay, continue going. West. All that trading post.
Resting would be nice, don't you think?
You wanna rest again? What? Okay, manage. Okay, begin resting, side of town. Oh, I didn't cook very good. Oh well. I think that's about it. The prologue is finished. I think most of the tutorial is finished also. Thank you guys for listening. Hope you enjoy this. This is just the beginning of the game, and I'm gonna record a little bit more and put like my adventure into this. Thank you for listening, guys. Subscribe and like, please. It's really helpful. Helps the channel. It gives you motivation each time I get subscribers. And yeah. Goodbye.